Cecile Thibault worked with the New Orleans Police Department Mobile Crisis Unit for 7 years, serving as a volunteer for several years before that. The licensed clinical social worker loved her job, but she is now leaving the force. Cecile Thibault's resignation shocked many, but she said it was time, and she explained her decision to WDSU.
The administration had made overnight some internal changes with my program. Without my knowledge, I did not know the changes that were taking place. And the changes that took place were not changes I was comfortable with.
NOPD mobile crisis leader Cecile Thibault said it was time for a change.
There's such a need for education, and I'm 51 years old now, so to be moving off the streets, you know, in that capacity isn't all that bad. But I certainly have a tremendous amount to share and to teach others.
Over the years, Thibault has worked with thousands of mentally ill patients.
But we go in and de-escalate the situation and then certainly get them safely transported to the nearest emergency room if needed.
Answering more than 300 calls for help a month.
So there are a lot of folks that are really sick. Most of these people calling are suicidal, homicidal, and or gravely disabled. Working with people with chronic mental illness is tricky because of the non-compliance. So I would say 70% of my calls would involve somebody that was supposed to be on medication, but not, and often self-medicating themselves with drugs or alcohol. Hence, that would sort of lead to sort of wild and crazy behavior that would end up in a 911 call.
After Katrina, the number of mental health beds in places like Charity Hospital disappeared, leaving those who were the most vulnerable without a place to go. Thibault continued her work on the street and on television, answering mental health questions every Monday during Six on Your Side Live with WDSU anchor Norman Robinson.
In a mental health way?
Well, I am finding as I'm going into people's homes that people are having a serious, serious hoarding issue.
One of the most difficult days on the job was in January 2008 when fellow NOPD officer Nicola Cotton was shot and killed by a mentally ill man who had just been released from a hospital. That pushed Thibault to work harder for better inpatient, outpatient, and residential care.
I have seen so much success in that arena. We were fortunate to get Judge Calvin Johnson, who was retiring from the bench, and we were able to get him over to Metropolitan Human Service District, and we were able to get this amazing doctor down from Minnesota, and they did an entire overhaul of our community-based mental health programs, and they are fantastic.
She is proud of her achievements, but knows she has more to contribute.
It is very personal. It is definitely stolen my soul, and there's a lot to be done. There's a lot of misconceptions about people with chronic mental illness, and I'm really working to try to change that. So I'm on a mission, and my mission is to really make sure that they don't get lost, that they don't fall through the cracks, that they're not having to live in the shadows of our community.
The mother of three has not been specific about where she will go next, but says her work will deal with the mentally ill. She's glad to see law enforcement getting more education in terms of mental illness. The Department of Justice recently upped the hours of crisis intervention training for new police recruits from 4 to 40 hours. We wish her well.